New Japan iPPV.
Yes.
Tell me about it.
It was really, really good. Man, they, you know, just a really good show. I'll go through the match by match. It was the opener was Alex Shelley and Kushida won the IWGP Junior Tag Team Championship from Rocky Romero and Alex Kozlov. The funnest thing about this match, well, actually the funnest, because the match was very well wrestled. It was just short. I mean, this one wasn't nearly as good as the match that these teams had a month ago, or that you would expect these two teams to have, just because they just didn't have the time to have it. But what they did was fine. But the very beginning of the match, Alex Kozlov told the ring announcer to tell everyone that he wants everyone to stand while he sings the Russian national anthem. So the ring announcer, you know, tells everyone to stand as he sings the Russian anthem. And you know what happened?
I will bet that everyone stood up respectfully.
Everyone stood up respectfully, and then he sang the Russian national anthem. And then when it was over, awesome. You know what happened?
They all sat down.
They all clapped.
Huh.
So that's what happened. I thought that was hilarious. It, you know, it was just so funny, you know, having to do that. He's not the best singer in the world. He's a much better wrestler than he is a singer. But anyway, the second match was 10-person tag, just kind of getting guys on the show. Tomohiro Ishii, Takashi Iizuka, Jado, Toru Yano, Yoshihashi against Jushin Liger, Tiger Mask, Captain New Japan, Manabu Nakanishi, and Negro Casas. And Toru Yano pinned Nakanishi with a low blow and a cradle. The match was okay. It was short. Some parts were pretty good. Tiger Mask did a double arm superplex while standing on the top ropes on Yoshihashi. You know, Ishii's offense was pretty good. Nakanishi was barely in. But it was, you know, I mean, when Liger came in, they treat Liger. Liger and Nakanishi were the two most over guys. When they were in, the crowd was pretty much, you know, hot for them. Then we had Minoru Suzuki and Taichi against Yuji Nagata and Ryusuke Taguchi, which had a surprise ending because Minoru Suzuki gave the Gotch pile driver to Yuji Nagata, and then Taichi pinned Nagata. And, you know, if you know how Japan works and hierarchy and things like that, the idea of Taichi pinning Yuji Nagata is like a real big deal, and the people popped really big. Taichi's got a lot of charisma. He's a young guy. Now, he's not even really all that young. He's been around for a long, long, you know, he's been around, I don't know how long, but probably 10 years. But he's got a good look and all that, and then, you know, this match was all okay. It was good. You know, it's kind of funny because, you know, I mean, like the match that Minoru Suzuki match that he had on the last pay-per-view was like match of the year. And then this match was just they worked, you know, this is the thing with them. Like when the veterans like Nagata and Suzuki, it's like when they're in the main event, they kick ass, you know, both of those guys. And when they're in the third match, they wrestle like they're in the third match. I mean, it's like they understand their role, and they're not out there trying to, like, they'll do enough to make a good match, which it was, but they're not out there trying to do a 4-star match. And then, I don't know if you would say they're holding back or they're protecting their bodies or however you want to phrase it, but they're doing what you do. I mean, it's like they understand the difference between when you're in a prelim, you get the match over as a prelim and you don't steal the show. And when you're in a main event, you try to steal the show. And so anyway, that's what happened there. Then we had Satoshi Kojima and Hiroyoshi Tenzan challenging Davey Boy Smith Jr., or Harry Smith, and Lance Archer for the IWGP Tag Team titles, which ended with the Killer Bomb, which is a double-team power bomb, Harry Smith and they did it to Tenzan, and Archer pinned Tenzan. Good match. You know, they some nice clever spots. I like Kojima and Tenzan as a team. They're so much better as a team than they are as individuals. There's something about them together where the crowd's really into them a lot, and it was good. Low-key Prince Devitt, tremendous match. Not as good as the one they had. They had a match earlier in the year that was just great. And this was great, too, but it was shorter. It was, you know, not, I don't know. It was just tremendous. I mean, every single thing they did from start to finish was awesome. I mean, just freaking, I don't know. Just the way they did, like, a lot of crossover spots where you would think that they were doing one thing and they actually did something else a lot of times. Or, like, there was one spot where Devitt, monkey flipped. Like, it's like he did the, not the monkey flip, but like a catapult. Like, you know, you throw the guy into the corner. And when he did it, Loki jumped on the top rope and came back with a double foot stomp on Devitt. It was just awesome the way that was done. And they both did situations where they had the other one on the table over the guardrail where the announcers sit, and the other one would go to the top rope, and it was like, oh, my God, they're going to go off the top rope through the announcer's table. But in both cases, in fact, that didn't happen. They didn't do anything. There was nothing, like, really crazy, but just, you know, good stuff all along. And then the finish was Devitt winning the championship when Loki went for the key crusher, and Devitt turned it into a small package. And that was the deal. And looks like they're going to do a three-way dance at, this show. Here we are in November. They set up January 4th show, you know, pretty good, because I think they're going to do a three-way with Loki, Devitt, and Kota Ibushi. Then they announced the tag team tournaments teams for which the next tour. Not every team is like a star with a guy who can drop falls. I mean, no. Tenzan and Kojima are both stars, and I guess that, you know, Archer and Smith, because they're tag team champions. But, you know, either of them can drop falls. I mean, it was you would have a team with a star and a guy who, you know, is. I mean, I guess Hiroki Goto and Carl Anderson are both pretty much at the same level. But, you know, like Tanahashi's teaming with Captain New Japan, just an example in the thing. Hold on. We had Kazushi Sakuraba and Katsuyori Shibata against Wataru Inoue and Togi Makabe, which was really fun, but a short match. Very good, mostly because of Shibata and Makabe, who are building themselves up for a singles match, and they brawled all over the place, stiff brawling, good stuff. And Sakuraba used a Kimura on Inoue, which is one of the moves that he used, on Henzo, the Henzo Gracie finish. And, just good. Then we had Kazuchika Okada and Hirooki Goto, and this was for the Money in the Bank briefcase. But in Japan, the difference is, unlike with Dolph Ziggler, where he won the briefcase and then proceeded to lose 46 straight matches, here, when Okada won it by winning the G1, they announced that if he loses a match, then the guy who beats him gets the briefcase. So this was, I think, the last challenge before the Tokyo Dome, the last time he was going to be in a singles match. So Okada won, and very, very good match. These two worked together so well. Again, a lot of cross-up spots, just good stuff, almost great. And Ghetto at ringside, tremendous, for, you know, in Okada's corner. Okada won with the Tombstone Piledriver and the Sith, the Rainmaker, which is just a short, stiff lariat, and, so they're protecting his finish pretty good. And, you know, he beat the guy clean in the middle. It's like to build up. He's going to headline the Tokyo Dome. I mean, just purely logical booking. Then Shinsuke Nakamura defends the Intercontinental Championship against Machine Gun Carl Anderson. Also, really, really good match. Nakamura won with a running knee. Anderson is a great, great wrestler. At the end, when Joe Rogan asked Nakamura, you know, who do you want to wrestle next? He did not say that whoever Joe Silva and Dana White say. He said, "Sa ku," and as soon as he said that, the place just popped like that. You know, he didn't even finish the name. He didn't even finish the name, and they were already popping. So anyway, it's Nakamura and Sakuraba, Intercontinental Championship, most likely the Tokyo Dome. But I was surprised. Maybe I shouldn't be so surprised at the reaction. Sakuraba is a big star, but it was quite the reaction. And then main event was Hiroshi Tanahashi and Yujiro Takahashi for the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. And this was a challenge because I'm willing to bet that every single person in that building had already kind of figured out that the main event at the Tokyo Dome was not going to be Yujiro Takahashi against Kazuchika Okada. So Hiroshi Tanahashi was going to win. But they still got them buying a lot of the stuff in the near falls. And outstanding match. Nothing like last month. Put it this way, it's better than Jeff Hardy and Austin Aries last night. So, I mean, just an outstanding match, best match on the show, great world title match. So, yeah. I mean, the interesting thing to me is, it did well in Japan, of course, but literally nobody orders this stuff outside of Japan. I mean, it, as great as this stuff is, and as you know, the first show, you know, this I wouldn't say like this was the best card of the year, although this would probably be among. I mean, this was a great card, but nothing like last month. But you know, they're coming off of that great card, and you know, the fact that New Japan pretty much has been delivering all the time. I mean, it's just amazing how nobody orders these pay-per-views. So anyway, that's the deal. Great show though.